The build went seamlessly. I really enjoy how everything looks. It's small and compact, yet there's still plenty of space. Look, we can cram a full GPU in here. Hey everyone, Digital David here. Today on this episode of Newegg Now, I'm gonna be checking out the Cooler Master Masterbox NR200P. I did receive this case to review, but any opinion expressed in this video is strictly my own. That being said, if you're interested in this product, you want to find out more about it, the link to it will be in the video description. Be sure to check out some of the other Cooler Master reviews that we have on the channel, as well as some other Newegg Now episodes. So for this specific case, we have the tempered glass version. Our color is sunset orange. They have 6 color options available. You can see from this side a lot of the quick tech specs for this case. Then we can learn about the features on the back side as well. So the tagline is big features, small size. Now let's go ahead, let's open it up and look at the contents. Here are all the package contents. First up, you can see we have our user guide and manual walking us through everything we need to know about this case, how to remove and install every part and component. So there it is from the front side. Here it is from the back side. Again, everything is charted out for you step by step, everything you could possibly need to know right there for you, all set up and ready to go. Next, you can see we have our GPU vertical mounting bracket if we want to use that. 2 included case fans. And you can see we have our hardware kit right here with our zip ties. We also have a nice fan splitter cable right here. We have our tempered glass as well, nice and protected for us. So you can see that from both sides. And last but not least, we have the case itself. Let's go ahead, let's look at that in more detail. Here's a look at the case from the top. Check it out. You can see our ports and IO right here, our power button front and center, USB, and our audio port. We can also remove the top cover as needed. It just pops right off like you see here. Check out the inside there. Everything looks great. Now you can see a nice top-down view of the internals of this case. Everything is removable on this, which is really nice in regards to all of the panels. So that's the top panel. Let's go look at it from the front now. So you can see here's our front panel right there with the Cooler Master logo and branding, just a nice metal panel. And we can pop this one off too. So check that out. We just removed it. Now we can look at it with the front panel removed. You can see all of our cables running through there too for the front IO. And we have our pump mounting options too. You can see it's even labeled pump for you. Plenty of space. Whatever you want to do with this build, you'll be able to get it done. And then this just snap right back on gently like that. Now let's look at it from the backside. You can see we have different PCIe options right here. So we could do a vertical mount GPU if we want. Here's where our motherboard IO is going to go. You can see our power connector right there. Everything looks great. I really like the orange and black color scheme. Pay attention to this screw right here. If we need to remove the bottom to mount a cooler or a radiator, we can do that. And we also have a removable screen. Nice magnet on it. Really cool. If we want to clean that built-in filter, we can do that. Now let's look at it from the sides. So we just pop off the sides. They kind of just come out like you see right here. So check that out. We're gonna swap this one out with the tempered glass, but you could use either option. And now we can see our case from this side. So check it out here. We got a hard drive bracket and mount. If we wanted to use this, we could, or we can remove it. You can see on the inside, we have all of our IO cables again. So USB 3.0, HD audio, and you can see we have our front panel connectors right there. Plenty of room and space in here for whatever we desire to do. Now let's go ahead. Let's remove the back panel as well. So we just kind of gently, if we can grab it, pop it out just like that. And you can see these are removable on the inside if you want. So we can easily clean and manage those. And now you can see what it looks like from this side as well with our power supply bracket right here that we can mount in. Looks great. We have our cable management options too, so we can tidy and clean everything up. Because you may have noticed there's just really not much room on this side. Everything's flush to the case basically. So a lot of room there. You can see me through there. Looks great, very small and compact. Now let's go ahead, let's start our build. Here are all the parts and pieces going into the build here. First up, we have our Lexar 1TB M.2 drive, followed by some G-Skill RAM, 2 sticks of 16GB, bringing it to 32GB total. Then we have our AMD Ryzen 5 5600G that does have integrated graphics, because you may notice we're not using a GPU with this build. You can see our motherboard right here from Asus. Love this motherboard, looks fantastic, very small and compact, perfect for this case. Then you can see our nice low profile air cooler right there from Cooler Master. We have a 1-to-5 splitter cable for our RGB. You can see we have our Cooler Master 650 watt small form factor power supply, two additional ARGB 120 millimeter fans from Cooler Master, and the two fans that are included with this case. Now let's go ahead, let's get everything built. So the first thing we're gonna do is prep our motherboard and get it all set up and ready to go. So we're gonna install the M.2 drive, our CPU, our RAM, and our bracket for our cooler. So let's go ahead, let's do that right now. So now we're ready to prep the case. You can see I got all the panels removed. We can also remove that front panel if we needed to. In this case, we're gonna leave the power supply bracket right where it is, but if we wanted to, we could rotate it and mount it right here. That being said, we're gonna take the two included fans and you can see we're gonna press them right in place. So very easy install right here. Just press it in and we do that for all four of them. So you can see one's in, two, three, and four. Pay attention to how I have the cables run right here. So since this is gonna go on like this up top, I wanted those cables for the fans to be running down the backside so I can tuck them in and manage them a little bit easier. So there we go. We have two of our exhaust fans already installed. And then we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna take the two additional ARGB fans. We're gonna install them on the bottom right here, pulling in some air for us. So next up, let's go ahead, let's prep the power supply. So for this step, we need to go ahead and take off this bracket right here. So you can see we have two screws that we have to undo on this side. Once you take those screws off, you can see then the bracket will just fall down right here and it's still being secured by these two Velcro straps. So let's go ahead, let's remove those and take it out. So there we go, we got it removed and now we're ready to attach it to our power supply. So we're gonna want it to go just like this. And then we can look in there and you can see the holes will line up. So we'll be able to put a couple of different screws in to secure this bracket in place. So then we can mount it right back up in the case. So there you go. You can see we use four screws that were included with the power supply to put the bracket on. It fits great, looks really nice. We can see that from all different sides and angles. Now we're ready to reattach this to the case. So now you can see the motherboard's all set up and ready to go. Our CPU's installed, our cooler, our M.2 drive, our RAM. You can see we also connected our CPU fan already to the motherboard. And you can see what it looks like on the backside with our CPU cooler's bracket. So now we're ready to put it in the case. To get our power supply unit installed for this particular case, we had to attach a bracket to it that mounts to the backside of our case. So you can see we use four of the included screws with the power supply to fit the bracket right on it. And now to finish installation, you can see we're gonna line it right back up here. You can see it's gonna hang down right there and we're gonna fasten it back with the two screws that came with the case. So here it is fastened back to the case with the two included screws. And there we go, you can see we have the power supply unit successfully installed. Now we went ahead, we removed the bottom piece. So you can see we have one screw to remove the panel right here and then it just pops right off. And we're ready to install the two 120 millimeter fans. So you can see what this is gonna look like right here. So we're gonna flip this around. Those are gonna go on the inside. We're gonna line up the holes just how we want it and take the four screws for each fan that are included with the fans and fasten them in place. So here you go, you can see I got the fans installed right here exactly how I want them. Also, I wanna point out, if you're not happy with the adjustment by default of the toggle switch for high, medium, or low, be sure to configure that before you tighten them in place. But you can see it from both sides right here. I purposely have the cables on this side too, so again, when we put it back in the case, they're gonna be away from the tempered glass and we can try to clean them up a little bit better. But now that this is installed, we're all set and ready to go to put it back on our case. So there we go, the screws fastened securely, it snapped back in place. We can see it from the bottom right here, and then you can see it from the inside and the top down view now and where our RGB fans are going to be. So check that out. It's gonna look great illuminating right there below the motherboard and the power supply. Now we went ahead and connected all the power supply cables that we're gonna need. So you can see we got our main motherboard connector right there and our CPU power as well. Looking at the top of it, you can see how we connected the included power cable and at the top right there. I also went ahead and I tucked in a PCIe cable down here for future reference in case we ever wanna add a GPU, since this build is gonna be using an integrated GPU. I tend to lose cables and misplace them, so it's nice just to sneak it right in there and nobody will notice. So at this step, I'm actually gonna call an audible right here. I feel like this is too many fans for the build and I'm not worried about the thermals with this case. Even with the tempered glass on, we'll still have the vented side panel in the back, and from the bottom, I feel like it's gonna be able to naturally just pull in air, cool air from the bottom. So we're gonna swap the two fans that I installed on the bottom with the two fans that I installed on the top of the case. And then these two fans that were included, I'm just not gonna use them in the build. So here we go, the fan swap is complete. So now it's time to get the motherboard installed. You can see we have our IO shield already snapped in place on the back of the case. You just bring it in right here, line it up and gently press it in. Now we're ready to drop the motherboard in. So you can see we have four standoff brackets. You may need to pull these out of the way to give you enough space. And just gently line everything up so the Wi-Fi antennas can come in, the USBs, everything we have back there. There we go. Now you should see that it's fully seated and we're ready to fasten it in place with four screws. So you should have 12 of these screws included in your kit, and then we'll just drop them right in place and tighten them down. So now you can see we have successfully installed the motherboard and fastened it down. Now that our motherboard's installed, we're ready to connect all of our power supply cables. So first up, you can see we have our CPU cable right here. We're gonna run that right through and it's gonna get plugged in right up here in the top left-hand corner. Then our last power supply cable we're gonna connect is our main motherboard cable. And this is gonna drop down right in here so you can see where that is going to be connected. So it's just gonna drop and snap in place right there. So now you can see what it looks like with both of those cables connected. Now we're ready to plug in the rest of our cables right here. So you can see we have our HD audio. That's gonna go right here under this cover. We may need to remove with the Phillips head screwdriver. Then you can see we have our front panel connector. That's gonna drop down right in here and get plugged in. Page 1-18 in the user guide manual is gonna walk you through the correct setup for that. And I do wanna point out they have this nice cover on there keeping everything together for us. Then you can see we have USB 3.0 for our front panel. That's gonna go right in here. And pay attention to how this notch is lined up. It's only gonna fit one way. So you can see that's our front panel connectors. And then everything else we have to connect is gonna be our fans and our RGB. So here's a close-up of all the connectors right here. So in the end, I did have to undo that screw to connect the HD audio. Then you can see going further along, we have our USB 3.0 right there. Then we have our front panel connector just pushed right down in place, really nice. Main power supply. You can see over here, first up we have our 5-pin splitter for our RGB. Then you can see we have our chassis fan, which is gonna have an adapter for us so we can attach both fans to this motherboard. Then you can see where our CPU fan's installed. And lastly, we have our connector right here for our CPU power from our power supply. So that's a quick close-up look of all the connections on this board. Keep in mind there's USB Type-C if you have that connection for your build if you're using this motherboard. And then you can see we have our USB 2.0 connection right there as well. So there we go. That's just a quick look at all the connection options on this board that we used in this build. Lastly, you can see we have our fans connected right here and we have all of our RGB connected as well for our cooler and the two fans that you see here. We have plenty of extra connectors with our splitter cable now. So at this stage, we can put everything back together and boot it up. I wouldn't recommend cable managing just yet. It's always great to make sure your PC posts before you spend a lot of time tidying everything up. So let's go ahead, let's put the top back on and see if it fires up. So now it's time to see if everything will post. So let's go ahead, let's power it on. And there you go, you can see everything's booting up. It's just gonna take a minute for our monitor to activate as well with our motherboard BIOS settings. If for some reason yours is not booting up, troubleshoot by updating the BIOS first. Make sure you have the latest BIOS firmware installed. So follow that procedure and then try again. And maybe, just maybe, that'll help you out with any issues you may have with your build. I know for me, I had to go ahead and make sure the BIOS flashback was updated and then it worked great. So make sure all your cables are connected. And then if you're still having issues, make sure that your BIOS is up to date for the 5600G. But there you go, you can see it booted just fine and everything's working great. Now let's go ahead and manage our cables. So here's a look at the final build with our cables managed. You may have noticed too, our CPU power cable now is routed behind and underneath the motherboard. Everything else is just tucked away nicely, zip tied together. Most of it I was able to get bailed out, I feel like, between the two fans. So everything's nice and snug under there, zip tied together. Really happy with how everything turned out with this build in regards to cable management. I wish I could make this a little bit prettier. Not sure in the future if I got like a longer extension cable, I could maybe run it that way and that might look a little bit better. And unfortunately with this board, the HD audio, there just really wasn't much I was able to work with there. And I still wanted to keep this slot open in case we ever want to add a GPU to this build. But let's go ahead, let's shine a light into. You can see how everything looks in there. Get a feel for how everything kind of came together with this build. But overall, very pleased and impressed with this case and what we're able to fit inside and how much room we still have. Now that everything's finished, there's only one thing left for us to do. So satisfying. So overall, very pleased with this case. It's fantastic. The build went seamlessly. I really enjoy how everything looks. It's small and compact, yet there's still plenty of space. Look, we can cram a full GPU in here, horizontally or vertically, whatever we want. Don't forget, we can reroute the power supply if we wanted to mount it to the front panel, or we could use that front panel for some additional storage, or if you wanted to mount a pump, if you want to do some custom water cooling. You have a lot of flexibility with this case. And I can't stress enough how good this case looks in person. This sunset orange is a fantastic color, but there's six colors to choose from. I think in the future, the only improvement I would make to this case right now would be, one, I'd love the case fans that come with it to be RGB. That would be really cool if they had that built in. Two, maybe possible a way to kind of sneak a slightly bigger cable channel, maybe along the top or somehow maybe along the backside, so we could tidy up our cables even more. Some of the power supply cables just were really hard to cram in and tuck. I'm happy with how it turned out, but I'd love to have a little bit more room to really help that OCD in me get resolved. And lastly, maybe some USB-C up top. It'd be cool if we had the option to have a USB connector up there, especially because the motherboard I picked does have that. So you can't have too many USB, at least in my opinion. But overall, really pleased with this case. It looks great and it's really easy to build with. Well, that concludes our video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, the product link will be in our video description below. Please go ahead, check it out and do your shopping from there. Any purchase made through that link helps support our channel at no additional cost to you. So we're really grateful and thankful for all of your support. While you're at it, can you go ahead and hit that like button for us? And subscribe to our channel. We have new content coming out daily and we don't want you to miss anything. Please go ahead and give us a follow online and make it a clean sweep. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Twitch, TikTok, Discord. You can message us on WeChat, check out our website, and join our free newsletter. Thank you guys so much for being here. Don't forget, new content daily, and we can't wait to see you in our next video.